Hey there, it's Brandon, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to set up your Shopify store to do a test order. Test orders are great. I highly recommend you do one before you go live with your store. If you like these tutorials, go ahead and click the like and subscribe. Let's go ahead and jump right into it. Here we are in our Shopify admin screen down on the bottom left. Let's go ahead and click on settings. Within the settings menu, I want you to go ahead and click on the payments button there. Now, once you click on the payments button, we're going to be looking at the various payments that you can set up for your Shopify store. But what we want to do is set up for a test payment gateway, or in this case, it's going to be a bogus gateway where we can run transactions without actually conducting them. That way we can see the whole process. So if your store is totally new and you haven't opened, it probably looks like this. If you already have Shopify's payments set up, it may look like this. It's just a little bit different. You'll need to go into the manage button and then select pick third-party providers. But for this situation, we're going to work with a store that hasn't been opened and you haven't selected a payment provider. So right here below Shopify payments, you'll see a little blue link that says see all other providers. Let's go ahead and click on that. And that presents us with all these third-party providers that are available outside of Shopify payments. Don't worry about that. Right at the top, the second one down, is for testing the bogus gateway. That's exactly what we want to use. Go ahead and click on that one. It's going to pull up with a little bit of information about how to do the transaction. Don't worry too much about it because I'm going to walk you through it step by step as we continue on. So let's go ahead. Now, this green button here says reactivate for testing. Yours might just say activate for testing because I've been in and out of it a couple of times. So go ahead and activate that gateway. Once you have that in there, it's going to pull up the country and region that you're in that the testing can be done. And then you have the option later if you want to come back in and deactivate this to get a live gateway for that. Go ahead and click this back arrow. And that'll take us back to the payments section where we first started. Now, once we're here and this payment has been set up, we want to go back to the Shopify admin menu, go to online store, and let's go ahead and click customize. We want to actually go into the store. This is the theme editor. All right, and then right from the top here, this drop down, let's go ahead and pick a product. I have a default product in here. Whatever products you might have in your store, you can just select one. And when it pulls up here, we're gonna go ahead and do either add to cart or buy it now. So let's do a buy it now option. So the process of buying the product, you're always gonna be presented with the shipping page first. So as we go through this process, and this is why I always recommend setting up and doing a test order, is it just takes you through the process. You may have been working on these pages as you developed your store, but here we are, we're really close to actually opening it and we want to do a test order. So go ahead and put your information in here, just like someone would if they were ordering for their shipping information. And once you've loaded your shipping information in there, go ahead and click continue, and you're going to get to the payment or the shipping selection option here. So if you set up multiple shipping methods, then you can select that and pick that. For this demo store, we only have one shipping method available and it's already pre-selected. So you can go ahead and click continue to payment. Okay, so now we're on this final stage in the order processing where people will actually put in their payment information. You can see this store can't accept real orders because we're on a test network, and you can see that same symbol that was earlier shown on the bogus gateway. So for the credit card, we have a couple of different options for the card number. If you enter the number 1 for the card number, This is to help us simulate a successful transaction on a credit card. If you were to remove the one and instead use the number 2 for the credit card number, this would simulate a failed transaction on the credit card. If you don't go with the number 2, the other option is the number 3, and this is to generate an exemption type of error. That's not it's not showing that the transaction was approved or failed transaction. It was some other type of error occurred in the processing. Now those are the only numbers that you need to select from in the card. You don't have to enter a long credit card number that you normally would use, just that one single digit in there, depending on what kind of transaction you want to simulate. So we're gonna go with the number 1 for a approved transaction, and then we'll go ahead and put your name. Any name will work. Actually, I'm gonna go ahead and put test so I can kind of track that. For the expiration date, use any date in the future from the date that you're doing the test. And then for the security code, you can put in any 3-digit number that you want. So I'm gonna go ahead and put in 111. I'm gonna leave my billing address same as a shipping address. You can go ahead and fiddle with that if you want to do additional testing. And then let's go ahead and click the Pay Now button. Just like the customer would see, your order is being processed and you're gonna possibly get this error message. So it just depends if you have something going on in your situation. You may get this failed to load page. So I've gotten this before. However, we can continue on and we will still see the successful transaction. So don't worry too much about the try again or the view documentation. Once you close that out, now you're going to be presented with the successful receipt that a customer who orders from your website would also see. So you can see here, it's all the information that someone would automatically receive on the order, their confirmation, their shipping address and billing address is all there. Gives them the option to continue shopping, and it shows the total of their receipt. And that's why you want to do a test transaction. You want to go through this process and just see everything and how it's laid out and make sure that everything is okay. Now there's one other thing when you do a test order that you will also have the opportunity to check if you use your personal email address when doing the testing. So let me show that to you. So when I made my order as the test customer, I used my own email so that I would receive the email that the customer would receive. And here it is in my inbox in Gmail. So if you use your own email address, you'll be able to see what your customers. Now, all of this obviously is in the notifications. And in this video, I just want to stick with how to do a test order. But I do want you to know that one of the benefits of doing a test order is you can make sure that these automated notifications go out. Now, in addition to the customer getting this notification, you as the store owner would also get a notification. So let's take a look at that one. And here it is. Here's the notification that you would get as a store owner that someone placed an order in your store. And from right here, view order, if you click through, that will take you right back to your order section within your website. So you can come in here and you can work on it. There's a lot more to do in here. This was obviously a test order. But that's it, pretty simple. Something that I highly recommend you do a test order before you open your store so you can see the entire process. Everyone, I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you got some value out of it. I'll see you in the next one. Thanks for watching.